Good morning, Paisley. I'm Josh Tracy.
And I'm Sierra Still. Welcome to the Pride.
Today is a special day here at the Pride. It's the Halloween special.
It's going to be a spooktacular event. But before we get to the spooky stuff, let's go to set to see some weekend weather.
Sounds good.
Monty here reporting for Pace and High, and right now it looks like a blizzard's blowing through. It's about maybe 23 degrees outside, so bring your jackets. Now back to you, Steph.
Wow, Monty, that looks like quite the storm. Moving our way into Saturday, it looks like it's going to be raining cats and dogs, so better bring your umbrella. Then Sunday, it looks like there's a possible chance that there may be a flood of cats, dogs, and possibly lizards. But on a real note, it looks like it's going to be through the weekend mid-70s to low to mid-40s.
Man, it looks like the weather is going to be crazy this weekend.
I know. I'm hoping to get a free puppy.
Okay. Now it's the time you've all been waiting for. Drum roll, please.
Nice job, guys. Kason, Eric, and Cody have a segment put together for us about trick-or-treating.
So how old really is Jewel?
I don't know, Josh, but they're going to let us know right now. Let's go check it out.
Sounds fun.
How old is too old for trick-or-treating?
You never get too old for trick-or-treating unless you're like old and creepy.
I think once you're out of elementary school, you should be done.
You think it's too old for trick-or-treating?
You're never too old for trick-or-treating.
How old do you think it's too old for trick-or-treating?
It's never.
Ever?
Never ever.
You're never too old to trick-or-treat.
How old is too old for trick-or-treating?
You're never too old for trick-or-treating.
Never.
No, well, what's smart is you stay at your house and you just eat your candy.
I don't think you can be too old.
How old is too old for trick-or-treating?
I still go trick-or-treating.
And how old are you now?
17.
17?
General age of Payson High is 16, 17, and 18. Most students here still trick-or-treat. Let's see if more students trick-or-treat.
How old is too old to trick-or-treat?
I believe that there is never an age to stop trick-or-treating. My dad still trick-or-treats and he's like 40.
They say the age at which it's too old is 13.
How old do you think is too old?
Oh, honestly. It doesn't bug me when someone comes trick-or-treating and they're 17 years old. It's not a problem. If they're willing to dress up, I'm willing to give them a treat.
How old is too old for trick-or-treating?
12, 13
years old? What do you really think is too old for trick-or-treating?
12, 13.
How old is too old for trick-or-treat?
You're never too old to trick-or-treat.
I'd say about 11 or 12.
Never.
30.
30?
You're never too old to trick-or-treat.
Are you going to be trick-or-treating this year?
Oh, yeah.
What do you do on Halloween?
Well, if there's nothing to do, I go trick-or-treating, but usually there's like a party.
Like, if you have kids, then you can trick-or-treat till you're dead.
What do you do on Halloween?
My nieces and nephews, mostly. My cousins, just the little kids. I take them somewhere. My family don't. Like, the older people don't have to, because I still like trick-or-treating.
Well, it looks like everyone at Payson High School has their own opinions about trick-or-treating. Most, I gotta say, are in for it. They enjoy going out with family, friends, having a good time, going to parties, and all that jazz. Thanks for watching, everybody.
This has been Kason,
Eric,
Cody.
Enjoy the rest of the broadcast. What do you do for trick-or-treating? Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you.
Well, looks like everyone is enjoying trick-or-treating.
I know, I sure am.
Alright, it's time for one of the segments that I've been looking forward to. The Zombie Apocalypse Plan with Austin and Kim. Let's go check it out.
There ain't no grave can hold my body down. There ain't no grave can hold my body down. When I
How do you think the zombie apocalypse will start?
It's going to start from a cure created by the government to cure some sort of disease. It's going to come around and bite them in the butt.
The zombie apocalypse will start when a student in our chemistry lab does a really rotten experiment and leaves it unattended.
Well, someday someone will drink some rotten milk and you'll get very sick and eat everybody.
Well, in my mind, I have a picture of I Am Legend. So everybody's gonna die, you know? But there's only gonna be one person left. And my guess is that one person left is gonna be Clint Perry.
They're gonna send to some other country to test it out, further experimentations, and it's not gonna work. It's gonna become airborne and affect the entire world.
And then, all of a sudden, it will blow up to zombies everywhere.
So I think everybody's gonna die, somehow, maybe a disease that we can track from going into the lunchroom too much. And Mr. Perry's gonna be left, and then you just think I Am Legend.
What zombie movies have inspired you?
Zombieland. Walking Dead. Zombieland. And the Walking Dead series.
That's amazing.
It is.
Yeah.
Zombieland.
Zombieland.
Zombieland. Who is the zombie bait of your friends?
Porta Coons.
Olivia Mata.
It had to be Shelby Cook.
Annabelle Starr. Annabelle Starr.
Because they always go for more.
Always. Grab someone. Okay.
Brandon Hammonds.
Probably Dakota Lang.
Which celebrity superstar will be in your zombie group?
Does it have to be like real person? Can be like a cartoon?
I mean, Dylan.
Mario. Mickey Mouse.
John Dick.
George Lopez.
Bethany Kardashian.
You're surrounded by zombies. How do you react and what do you do?
Toss her in and run.
Well, I would run away because if I'm surrounded by a horde, there is no way I can take all of them out, so fighting would be useless.
Well, my body is a weapon, so I would fight off with my body, and then I'd use weapons and then do it too.
We'll be all ninjas on them.
We'll go ninjas on them. Pull out samurai swords.
I would throw you.
I was about to say that.
I would trip you and run.
There ain't no grave can hold my body down.
But I am so ready to fight those zombies.
Hey, Josh.
Yeah?
Have you ever wondered if Payson's, like, really haunted? Like, with all the stories you hear, like, it's hard not to believe.
I want proof before I start to believe in things like that.
Well, let's find out if the rumors are true. Jason, Mike, and Colin have a segment put together of all the Payson hauntings. Let's go check it out.
Sounds pretty good.
There was a little gal about maybe 12 years old sitting over by the piano. She was used to play the piano and stuff in this building, but she died for some reason when she was 12 years old and she never did leave the building.
The lady on Dead Files saw what she called a gremlin, but when she was explaining it, it sounded more like, to me, and a lot of people have said, skinwalker.
Guys,
guys feeling and all that right now?
I'm feeling pretty weird, kind of.
I'm feeling, I wouldn't say that I'm like scared, but I can feel like I
hands.
Like scared. Like
how,
I can.
That's how scared I am. I am so scared.
Like when we were back there, I heard some wood scratching, and like I was really weirded out, so I almost went in that room.
Do you believe now, Josh?
It's gonna take lots more to get me to believe. But I'll admit, that was pretty scary.
I know. I'm totally gonna go check out some of those places on Halloween.
All right, it's time for the weekly announcements. Sadie's is tomorrow. Girls, if you don't have a date yet, you're cutting it pretty close.
There's a social studies essay contest with cash prizes. Talk to a social studies teacher to find out more.
Now, the ACT is tomorrow. For all of you who are taking it, I'm so sorry.
Well, that's all for the pride. Make it last.
And have a great day, Basin Hack.